Okay. So last week we had tried several examples already using the commonly known kinematics formula that we have learned. We had learned since high school. So about and basically those formula came from calculus and physics, of course. So these are now the graphical interpretation of those formula. Yeah. So rectilinear motion can be understood as either as from the graphical interpretation as well as from the mathematical identity, yeah, the calculus itself. So the graphical interpretation method is quite simpler. This is the direct approach when motion of a particle along a straight line experiences a few trends where motion is governed by different equation for different parts of the journey. So this is the graph right there. So this is the graphical interpretation and this is the equations, yeah, two equations. First is the derivative and then the integral. From velocity, for example, can be achieved from the integral of acceleration. So here, when we have an acceleration over time graph, when we make integration and we will have the velocity difference between two time, yeah, between two time points. Then when we integrate further the velocity over time, we will have the displacement, yeah, of between two different time. So here, for example, when we have parabolic, yeah, this is parabolic distance. When we make derivation, the derivation will be a straight line and of a single gradient. When we make further derivation, it will be a flat line. It means it has a constant acceleration. If it is the acceleration is negative, then we will have a negative gradient. When we make, we do integration, we have a decreasing velocity. And we make, when we further do integration, when we will have this kind of inverse hyperbolic parabolic equation. Special notes on graphical interpretation and the condition when phi equals to zero. Actually, we had discussed this last week, but we will repeat again to now. So when phi equals zero, it means the particle starts from rest, or otherwise the particle changes direction when the velocity over time curve, yeah, the graph, crosses the t-axis. So it means changes the direction from positive to negative. Yeah, the velocity, when the velocity equals to zero. Or in other physical meaning, the particle finally stop. In the graph profiles, A to T graph, acceleration over time graph lines, between change in trend, not necessarily connected. Sometimes they are discontinued, okay? The acceleration over time. The V over T graph lines between change in trend must be connected, although not necessarily that the connection is smooth, can be a what you call it, piecewise linear function. In the ST graph means the displacement over time graph, the line between change in the trend usually is smooth, like we have seen here. Okay, so in the ST graph here on the bottom part, usually the changes is smooth. Okay, let's do this example. And for let's do it. Let's explain it directly first. A particle moves with a constant velocity of 108 km per hour from A to B for a duration of t seconds. Okay, then it decelerates constantly. Decelerates constantly means constant acceleration, but negative sign, for 4 seconds from B to C. The journey continues with a constant velocity of 54 km per hour from C to D for a duration of T seconds. If the total displacement from A to D is 2,880 meters, determine the time T and displacement from A to B. Okay. So we start by plotting the V to T graph. So from 108 km per hour, be careful with the units. So when usually we change them first into SI unit, okay, system international unit. So from kilometer per hour, we change to meter per second. 108 kilometer per hour becomes 30 meter per second. So I do not need to explain this change here, how to convert this. Please do it and find it yourself. I believe that you are semester 7 students, so should already understand how to change units. And then the other constant velocity is from C to D, 54 kilometer per hour, which becomes 15 meter per second. So then when we graph velocity over time graph, okay, so from A to B is 30 meter per second. The T is unknown yet. Then it decelerates. Decelerate means the velocity decreases, becomes 54 kilometer per hour or 15 meter per second here, half of the first velocity, moving from C to D. So from B to C is the time when it decelerates. If the total displacement from A to D, the S, yeah, displacement S is 2,880 meter, determine the time T here. So the time between A to B is the same as the time from C to D. Yeah, this is T also. Okay, then between B to C is 4 seconds. So from here, A to B, from the graph, yeah. So using graph, then we can calculate the distance being traveled. Okay, displacement, I mean, yeah. So the integral of V over T graph, 30 T, this is the integral will be the area under this 30 meter per second. 30 times T equals to the displacement between B and A, or SB minus SA. If the origin, SA is the origin point, the 0 meter, so here SB equals to 30 T. From BC, the graph here is a trapezoid, right? So the area will be half of this plus this times the 4 seconds here. So half of 30 plus 15 times 4, so equals to SC minus SB. So SB is 30 T, okay? So from here, then we obtain SC equals to 90 plus 30 times T. Then from C to D is another T second. So 15, the area will be 15 times T equals to SD minus SC. SD is 2,880, SC is 90 plus 30 T. So here we insert substitute into this equation. 15 T equals to 2,880 minus 90 plus 30 T. Okay, so from here, we can obtain the T. The T here is 62 seconds, right? So from here, then we can calculate SB. Right? SB is calculated from this one, 30 T. So 30 times 62 seconds equals 1,860 meter. Then, what else is being asked here? The displacement, yeah. Or otherwise, analysis can also be done for the whole duration from A to D. So area under the V to T graph, yeah, is dS, the displacement. So area AB plus area BC plus area CD equals to dS 30 T plus half 30 plus 15 times 4 plus 15 T here equals to SD minus SA, which is 2,880 meter. Okay. From there, we obtain 45 T plus 90 equals to 2,880 meter. So T equals to 62 seconds. Okay. Example here. So let's try to do this and give you 5 minutes. Yeah? A particle move on a straight line with the velocity profile shown as here. Now determine A, the acceleration, so this is velocity over time graph. Determine the acceleration when T equals to 7 seconds. 7 seconds means here, and 20 seconds is here. S when T equals to 10 seconds here. S means displacement, right? C, the distance traveled for the duration from 0 until 25 seconds. Yeah. Be careful, yeah. There is a displacement, there is distance traveled. So Okay. D is the displacement when t equals to 12 second, given when t equals to 0, and the displacement is minus 50 meter. So minus 50 meter is at the initial one. Yeah. So at t equal to 0, the initial point where it starts is minus 50 meter. Okay, so let's do it in 5 minutes. Give you 5 minutes to do it. Okay. Let's check your answer. Okay. So first is when the question is acceleration at t 7 and 20 seconds. So this is quite straightforward, yeah, because this is velocity. So it's just we need just to know to get the gradient, yeah, of that particular things, yeah. So at t equal to 7 second and 20 seconds, so the gradient between zero between O to B, okay, between 0 to 10 seconds is can be calculated using gradient. Okay, so we obtain the gradient to be 6.25. So the so for example here, then we obtain that the equation here between between 0 to 10 second here. This is the equations. 10x equal to 6y, so x plus y equals to 10, or y equals to 1.6 over 10 x, right? Then solving 1 and 2, y equal, times at a, times at a here is when it is at when the velocity equals to 0, yeah, is at the moment 3.75 second. So this is the graph of v of t. Then we draw, we change into acceleration over time. So until O to A, this is the acceleration. OA, then acceleration A to B is AAB. Then the area under the AT graph equals to the change of velocity. Okay, AOA equals to 3.75. This is the gradient that we have just obtained. So VA from VA minus VO. If VO is minus 6, then VA is 0. Yeah, from this graph, the VO is minus 6 meter per second, and VA is 0 meter per second. So from here, we put into this equation, and then we obtain the acceleration is 1.6 meter per square second, AOA. Okay, then basically this is 10 over 6. So from A to B, yeah, times 6.25. This 6.25 is the time. Yeah, A times t equals to VB minus VA. VA is 0. VB is 10 meter per second. Yeah, from here this is 10 meter per second. So we obtain AB also 1.6 meter per square second. So the same as with A, the acceleration from O to A. Observe that the velocity at zero, velocity at A, and velocity at B lies on the same straight line. That is why the acceleration between O to A and then A to B is the same, which is 1.6 meter per square second. Then the analysis can be also done from zero to B. Yeah, this is the previous solution which we proposed. Yeah. Basically, AOB times 10 equals to VB minus V0 equals to VO0 equals to minus 6, VB is 10. And we obtain similarly A0B equals to 1.6 meter per square second. At BC, the acceleration is 0. Why? Because here the velocity is constant. If the velocity is constant, the derivative is 0. No changes in the velocity, right? It means acceleration is 0. From C to D, it decelerate, right? If you look here, the velocity decreases. So it means it should have a negative acceleration. yeah, from C to D minus A C to D times 10, the time duration, equals to Vd minus Vc. The velocity at C is 10 meter per second, and at V and Vd is 10. Vd is 0 meter per second, so minus 10 ACD equals to 0 minus 10. So ACD, the acceleration is 1 meter per second, per square second. The positive sign here shows that the assumption ACD negative is correct. So actually then the ACD is negative 1 meter per square second. If you don't put minus here, your value here, ACD will have minus 1 meter per square second. So basically the same results. Okay, so the answer for A, then the acceleration at t equal to 7 seconds will be 1.6 meter per square second, and at 20 seconds will be minus 1 meter per square second. Okay, now B is the distance between when t equals to 10 seconds. So we can calculate by integrating this graph velocity over t as two time. Okay. The area under VT graph equals to the DS, the displacement change. So half times the negative 6 here times 3.75, this is 3.75, this is the area, this area, equals to SA minus SO. And SO here, S0 is minus 50 meter, minus 50 meter. So from here, we obtain minus 11.25. So since this area is beneath, yeah, under the horizontal horizontal axis of t, then the area is negative, equals to SA minus minus 50. So here we obtain at SA here at point A at 3.75 second, the displacement is minus 61.25 meter. Okay. Then we want to calculate at t at 10. So we further calculate by integrating this area. So half times 10 times 6.25, 10 is here and 6.25 is this. So SB minus SA, SA is from this value minus 61.25 meter. This is 31.25 equals to SB minus minus 61.25. SB equals to minus 30 meter. Correct? Are your answer correct for B? And for A?
No.
No. Okay. So if this comes in the observe, what will you do? Okay. Then from BC, the area will determine the displacement. Yeah, the displacement. So 10 the time 10 times 5, the duration here equals to displacement of C minus displacement at B. So 50 here equals to SC minus minus 30. Minus 30 comes from this value. So SC equals to 20 meters. So at this one is already to the right of the origin point. At CD, then it decelerate. So from half, then you do, you put, this is a triangle. So the formula for triangle is like this. Half times 10 times 10. Okay, equals to SD minus SC. SC is 20 meter, so SD is 70 meter. Okay. So if we are asked to draw the graph of the displacement over time, the graph will look like this. Okay, at the original position, it was minus 50 meter. At A was minus 61.5. This is the time where the velocity is at zero, so it changes position, changes direction of motion, and then it increases, increases, increases. At 10, it is minus 30 meter. Then at 15 second, it's 20 meter. At 25 second, it is at 70 meter. So at t equal 10 second, it is the distance, displacement is minus 30 meter. So then, when we were asked the distance traveled between for the duration between 0 and 25, what we is what we need to do is adding, yeah, 11.25 here, the subtraction between this, then plus 61.25 until this zero, plus 20, plus 50, so 70. Total is 142.5 meter. So that this is the distance traveled. Okay, the distance traveled basically is this path. Yeah. At t equal 12 second, so at t equal 12 second, what is the displacement? So displacement here will be at this value. Area under this VT graph ds, so 10 times 2 second, yeah, from 10 to 12, equals to SE minus SB. SB is known already in the previous calculation, which is minus 30 meter. So from here, we obtain SE equals to minus 10 meter. So using the ST graph, we can also estimate where the displacement is at 12 second, okay? But this is not that easy. So you have to use this kind of analysis, yeah, line analysis. Okay, so as we also obtain SE equal to minus 10 meter. This is easier. So from the velocity to over time graph, then you do integration to calculate the displacement at t equals to 12 seconds. So there are special cases, yeah. This is the formula which is we have learned it in high school, I think, in physics. This is velocity equals to initial velocity plus acceleration over time, okay. This is the connection between velocity and acceleration and displacement, v square. This can be derived, of course, using calculus, but during high school, we usually just memorize it, right? V square equal to u square, the initial velocity, plus 2 times the acceleration times the displacement, s minus s0. Then this another one, this is displacement equal to ut plus half at square. This is also from calculus. Yeah, s is the final displacement, s0 is the initial displacement, a is the acceleration, t is time taken to the final. Example 8, this is similar, so we are just going to slide through the slide. So the profile is shown here when t equals a, when t equals to 7 and 20 seconds, and then s equals when s equals 10 seconds. The same problem basically, but now we are going to calculate it using the formula that have just been given. So we label again. So this is similar like before. Then now we can calculate what is the initial velocity. It's minus 6 meter per second, right? At zero, at O. Then velocity at A is 0 meter per second. So the acceleration is AOA. The initial displacement minus 50 meter. Displacement at A is SA. Time between O to A is 3.75 second. So we use the formula V equals to U plus AT, the velocity at A here. This is to calculate the acceleration between zero and A. So from here, we obtain 1.6 meter per square second. The velocity from here, we can also, using this formula, we can know the displacement when T equal to 3.75, yeah, which is minus 61.25 meter. So basically, we obtain same answer as the previous method, only now using a formula. So similarly, then we use this to calculate at 10 second. The acceleration is the same, and SB, this which is at 10 second, is minus 30 meter. Then we calculate further between 10 to 15, yeah, 15 second. And we obtain ABC is 0 meter per second because it is flat also. And we can, this is calculated using the graph. So velocity at C equals to velocity at B. So when time is 5 seconds, so it means ABC between B to C should be 0 meter per square second. Then the distance is calculated using the third formula from which we obtain the SC is displacement at C is 20 meter. And finally, between C to D, there's a deceleration, yeah, because the velocity decreases. Yeah, the deceleration from this equation we obtain minus 1 meter per square second. Then to calculate the displacement at D, we put SC value, we put the deceleration at minus 1, we put the initial velocity at C, which is 10 meter, and the final velocity at D, which is 0. From here, we obtain SD equal to 70 meter. So then we can answer the acceleration at T equals 7 second, 1.6 meter per square second. A when T equals 30 second is also minus 1. The displacement at T equals 10 second is minus 30 meter. So then we can draw also the track or the path of the particle. Initially it is minus 50 meter. Moving to the left because the velocity is negative until point A at 3.75 second, then moving to the right. Then at B is minus 30 meter. At 20 second, it is at C. Yeah. And finally at D, it is stopping at 70 meter. So the total distance traveled will be 11.25 plus 11.25 plus 50 here, okay, plus 70. 142.5 meters. So we obtain the same value as different method. So in the example 7, we had used graphical method. In this example 8, we use the formula method, yeah, which is basically derived from calculus. Yeah, these three method, these three formulas. Okay. A particle is moving along a straight line with the acceleration A equals to T minus 3, where T is in seconds. When T equals to 0 second and V0 is 4 meter per second, plot the A over T and V over T graph for the duration of between 0 to 4 seconds. Okay. So first draw the A to T graph. Yeah. The A is a function, the acceleration is a function of time, yeah, T minus 3. So if you draw the graph, it looks like this, right? The gradient is 1. So when T is 0, acceleration is minus 3. When T equals to 3 seconds, acceleration is 0, so like this. Given the relationship between acceleration and time, which is a linear equation, straight line, so when T equals to 0, A is minus 3. T equals 3 seconds, A is 0. T 4 seconds is the acceleration is 1 meter per square second. So now the question is also V over T. Draw the V over T graph. Yeah, with A equals to T minus 3. So we do integration, yeah, finite integration. So V minus V0, initial velocity, integral equals to integral 0 to T, T minus 3 dt. Initial velocity is 4 meter per second. So from here we obtain V minus 4, yeah, from here equals to T square over 2 minus 3T, right? So with finite integration, there is no constant. Yeah. And also there is already being put here the initial velocity. So from here we obtain V, the velocity equation equals to T square over 2 minus 3T plus 4. This is a parabolic equation. The initial condition when T equals to 0, the velocity is 4 meter per second. When T equals to 5 second, V equals to 1.5 meter per second. So this is how when we graph it, okay? At 0 is 4 meter per second. So determine now to know the inflection point in parabolic, yeah? When the particle changes direction, that is when the V equals to 0, so T square minus 3T plus 4 equal to 0. We make factorization, okay? So this equal T square minus 6T plus 8, so becomes T minus 2 times T minus 4, right? Equals to 0. So the velocity is 0 when T equals to 2 second and T equals to 4 second. It looks like this. Determine the maximum and minimum value of V. That is when the acceleration is 0 or T equals to 3 second, right? From this graph, the acceleration is 0. So when velocity is constant, yeah, velocity is maximum or changes. Yeah. So minimum, yeah, in this case is minimum. So V equal to 3 squared over 2 minus 3t plus 4. We substitute t with 3 second. So we obtain the minimum velocity is minus 0.5 meter per second. So after t equal 3 second, then the velocity starts to increase again. Okay. Another example. So a car is moving at 72 km per hour along a straight road with the acceleration profile shown. If the car stops when t equals to t1, stops, that means determine the t1. Plot the vt graph. So this is the acceleration. Yeah? Determine the displacement when t equals to t1. So this is the acceleration profile. So acceleration does not need to be continuous. So this is like disrupted. Yeah? At between 0 to 2, the acceleration is minus 2 meter per square second. Between 2 to t1, the acceleration increases from minus 4 until 0. So label the change in trend is as dv from a minus t to vt, the area under the at graph. So from O to A, yeah, 2 times minus 2, this is the velocity change, equals to VA minus VO. Okay, V, the initial velocity is 72 km per hour, or equals to, you divide with 3.6, yeah, to obtain in meter per second. So be careful about the units. So this is kilometer per hour, you change to meter per second, divided by 3.6. So VA, so from here we obtain VA equals to 16 meter per second, the velocity at point A here, at 2 seconds. From A to B, the velocity, so this the area here under the graph is half times minus 4 times 2 to T1, right? 2 until T1 dt. This is dt, right? Equals to VB minus VA. The questions indicate that the car stops. When a car stops, means that the velocity is zero. So the velocity at B equals to zero. Okay? So dt equals to, from here, VB you put zero. VA you put 16 meter per second. Right? From there, we obtain dt equals to 8 seconds. So from this graph, T1 equals to 2 plus dt. So dt here is 8 seconds. At this point, it is 2 seconds. So T1 equals to 10 seconds. Okay. So that is all for now. Yeah, actually, there is one more EPT, but since time is up, that will be all.